heart sky higher than mountains. Kind of love could turn me inside out. I wanna be yours.
Hello, React Native developers. I hope you are well. William here, recording from beautiful Zurich, Switzerland. During the summer, I ran a really fun experiment, and this morning, I get to tell you all about it. So, let's talk about love. And the React Native developers' first love is, of course, the web. Most of us came to React Native because we love the web. We jumped at the opportunity to build truly native apps using web development skills. And with Expo, we get web development like agility to our projects. And the romantic plot thickens. As library developers, we solved some of our hardest technical challenges by getting inspiration from the web. Reanimated worklets are inspired from CSS worklets. With React Native Skia, we wanted to bring a big part of the web ecosystem onto React Native. And while working on this project, we found our most elegant solutions by taking inspirations on how these problems were solved on the web. So yeah, we think the web is pretty cool. Now, to power web experiences on React Native and Flutter, we use Canva Kit, a version of Skia compiled to WebAssembly. The bundle size, depending on your browser's capability, ranges from 2 to 3 megabytes. But this morning, we would like to make you a different proposition. Instead of downloading a 3 megabyte WebAssembly file, we're going to use a 20 kilobyte JavaScript polyfill. We call it Canva Kit GS, and we think you're going to have a lot of fun with this. Now, before we talk about how we are doing it, let's talk about the why. We had 3 use cases, which were our North Star, and that drove this experiment. The first one is React Native Skia. We want React Native developers to build great web experiences with a very small bundle size. The second use case is about compliance. If we manage to make CanvaKit.js indistinguishable from CanvaKit Wasm, can we use other Skia clients with it? For instance, Flutter. Can we run Flutter with a 20 kilobyte bundle? That's exactly what we want to show you this morning. And the last use case is about regular web, casual web development. If we put React Native and Flutter aside, truth of the matter is that CanvaKit is still the API we want to use for web development. By breaking down the silos between the different graphic APIs and offering a nice composable API, and we're going to have a look at that. How are we even doing this? Web browsers have some of the most sophisticated 2D engines you'll find, and Skia has a large portion of that market share. Now the question is, how much of these best-of-class capabilities are available to us developers? Some capabilities are exposed: path rasterization, shaders, image filters, blend modes, affine 2D transformations. And other capabilities are a challenge. The APIs are siloed with each other, for instance, shaders and image filters, and some APIs are simply not exposed to the developers. Path operations and effects, layers, 3D transformations, and text rendering. A Google engineer, Fernando Cerbonici, has done a very good job in defining the problem space and has wrote a series of RFCs that represents these missing capabilities onto the Canva 2D API. We found his definition of the problem space to be extremely compelling, and we got started by implementing polyfills for most of these RFCs. We added support for modern filters, allowing for both easy composition of advanced filters and allowing them to be used without dependencies to the SVG DOM. We added support for layers, which enable applying filters to groups. Once we had this version of Canva 2D on steroids, we had a solid foundation to implement the CanvaKit polyfill. We implemented the Skia Path API and path segmentations. We have a fun way to do test-driven development there. We build the example with the original CanvaKit version, and then we ask our test suite if CanvaKit.js produces the exact same results. We implemented shaders, currently available using the GLSL syntax. CanvaKit.js is an extremely experimental project. We've been focusing on Google Chrome support. We think Firefox support should come soon. And for Safari, we'll have to wait for new versions of Safari to come out. And we are trying to document the project boundaries and supported features as much as we can. Now, let's have our first look at CanvaKit.js.
We are into VS Code here and have the React Native Skia example app. This is the app that we ship, part of the React Native Skia open source project. And some of you have seen these examples countless time. So here we check for the APIs. So we have creations, images. I think you're familiar with some of these examples. I've made two changes to the project, which I'm going to talk about. But now there is a twist. So instead of loading Canva Kit through the load Skia function, I'm going to just remove this loading here. I'm going to import Canva Kit JS, a 20 kilobyte polyfill. And I have a function that tells me if we are running a polyfill or not. So let me just reload here. And I can open the console to check. And now polyfill is true. So we are tackling the native browser APIs directly and breaking the silos between the different graphic APIs. For instance, in this example, where we use blend mods from Canva2D, SVG filters to build a nice blur mask filter. And we didn't have to change a single line of code, and we gained a really big bundle size. So here we have the images. So the images load in a different way because we used the browser to decode the images. So here we don't decode images synchronously like we do in Skia. We decode them asynchronously using the browser APIs. And we have the gradients. These gradients, they happen to be exactly running the same code. If you run Google Chrome, behind the scene, it's using the same Skia code that you would use if you were to use Canva Kit. So really, really fun. So here we load an image, we have a shader, and we compose the two together, right? So we can, let's see, modify the shader. So I'm going to talk about this. So here I was modifying the wrong shader. So here that's the set. So I had to make two changes, and this example shows two changes well. So the first one is that we load the images asynchronously. So I had to use a different hook to load the image. I use HTML image. And the second change is that I had to write the shader twice, one using the Skia shader language and one using GLSL. So there are a couple of things here. The ergonomics to write the GLSL shaders is not great yet. And also there is a lot of tooling around the Skia shader language. And this shader language is converted into GLSL in the Skia backend. So maybe we can leverage some of the Skia tooling. So we could potentially in the future, hopefully, target the Skia shader language directly, but we have a make shader function. And if it's a polyfill, we use the GLSL syntax. If not, we use the SKSL syntax. And we have other demos, maybe the digital rain. So here we use we parse the font table, we polyfill everything, we can do the glyph table reading. And here again, another shader. So here we rewrote the shader using GLSL. So really fun way to polyfill Canva Kit. I remember at the ApJS conf after party, someone asked me how small we could go with supporting Skia on the web. And back then, I had no idea that we could go as small as 20 kilobytes. And I had no idea also that we could go as far as we are doing now. So very experimental. We had to do quite some changes. But I think this has leg. I remember in 2000, I think it was summer 2018, I think I saw the first Flutter web demo running. I think it was running Canva Kit. And it was very clunky. But I remember I was very impressed because I obviously, how long is it going to take until they make the demo perfectly, like, butter smooth? And indeed, it took a very short time from this super clunky demo to be pixel perfect. And I think here, this is a very similar situation where this is highly experimental, but clearly this has, I think, really strong legs. And we think this can help React Native developers to build, like, rich web experiences. And speaking of Flutter, we have built React Native Skia, so we understand which API calls are made, and we were able to change the project a little bit so we can make the demo work. But what if we use another Skia client, and what if this client is a complete black box to us, so we cannot change anything, namely Flutter? So we've done this experiment. So here we took a Flutter web demo, and we didn't touch the source code at all. We didn't do any changes. We just swapped the CanvaKit WASM file with CanvaKit.js. So Flutter has no idea that there is a polyfill behind or anything. And it kind of works. So you can see the layouts of the text are wrong. So here so React Native Skia doesn't have text layouts. Here we're implementing something very quickly just for the demo, and we have scrolling, and the action seems to work. And I was wondering what happens if we do have, like, proper text layout. How would this demo behave? I was, like, curious to see, you know, what's missing. And so what I did is that this is the same demo, but here you can see that the text layout is correct. So what happens here is that this is running the polyfill, but when it comes to doing text layout, we use the real CanvaKit. This was an experiment to see how far we can go if we were to implement text layout properly. And I think it looks pretty good. I mean, not pixel perfect, but you know, I think it's cool. Like, we didn't touch anything from the source code. So I think it's a really strong proof of concept that, you know, with a little bit of coordination, we could go quite far, and we could provide really rich web graphic experiences to developers. Now I would like to show you one last demo where we put React Native aside, we put Flutter aside, and we look at casual vanilla web development. Here we have the example app from CanvaKit.js, and here we're not using React Native or Flutter, nothing fancy, but I want to show you that in this small package, just by using the imperative API, we do have access to a lot of very interesting primitives. So for instance, here we parse an SVG path, we calculate its transform to fit the screen, and we can trim, so animate using a trimming property. So there is no dashed hog offset or crazy thing like this. We just segment the path as it should be. We apply a gradient on it. So we are, again, breaking silos, because here we have different web graphic APIs that play together nicely and that can be composed with one another. So here we set the stroke cap, stroke join, the gradient shader, but we can use a different shader than a gradient. So here I took this shader from Shader Toy, and I can apply it directly. It's animated using a progress value. And now I'm drawing the path with a shader. So we've broken silos between different web API in a very, I think, compelling way. So this is the kind of, even if there were no React involved, this is the kind of web API I would want to use for casual web development. But now, of course, we want to use the power of the React programming model for extreme composability. And I'm going to show you a plain React project. So I'm simply going to create a React app here. And I'm going to install React Native Skia, but also CanvaKit.js. Here it's interesting because React Native Skia doesn't use React Native Web anymore to build a web experience. So effectively, it's just React Skia. And since we're going to use CanvaKit.js to target the web native web APIs directly, effectively, this is just React. So let's have a look. Here I have the React app, and I just installed React Native Skia. But the point here is that React Native Skia doesn't depend on React Native Web anymore. And it doesn't depend on CanvaKit WASM anymore as well. We use CanvaKit.js that targets the native web APIs directly. I load it here. And here I copy pasted the example from the React Native Skia app. So we target the web APIs directly, highly experimental project, but we think that this is a really cool proof of concept. I think for early adopters, it's going to be require quite a lot of work. There is a lot that needs to be taken into consideration for these things to run smoothly. But we think it's a really interesting way to approach web graphic development for the web. So I'm really curious to know what you guys will think about this.
And that's CanvaKit.js, a 20 kilobyte polyfill of CanvaKit. We use it to bring rich web experiences in React Native. We like its compliance so much that we even ran it against Flutter Web. And we think that this is going to be a delightful companion for casual web development. This project wouldn't be possible without the Start React Native members. Your support is what enables us to make such crazy experiments. So today, we are making the project available as a technical preview to all members. And I am quite eager to hear your feedback. If the appetite for the project is strong, we will be engaging with industry partners to make this project open source as fast as possible. So I am looking forward to talk to you soon. And until next time, happy hacking. Oh.